second. So while we live in this stuff, I'm also lifting up the fact that we deserve to live long lives. We deserve to live lives where we not just survive, but we thrive, right? We deserve that. We are worthy of that. God placed us here, and we deserve that. So if we're lifting up Sonya Massey's name, let's say her name again. Why are we here?
Sonya Massey.
Why are we here?
Sonya Massey.
We lifting up Kimberly King. We're also lifting up Katherine Johnson, who died at 92 years young by police. We're lifting up Ayani Stanley Jones, who died at age 7, who now would have been about 18 or 19 years old if she did not get cut down dead sleeping in her home. Because our homes are supposed to be safe, right? Home is supposed to be where we have safety, refuge. It's a sacred space for us. But too many times, Black people continuously get murdered and cut down in their homes where we are supposed to be safe, right? And like we said before, police will never keep us safe. It's a system that was built to terrorize Black people and terrorize communities of color and terrorize those that are not white, cis, hetero, and rich. Again, police will never keep us safe. And I know some folks kind of tether the line of, okay, if we don't have police, because I'm an abolitionist as well, I believe we should abolish all this shit. I don't believe in reform. I believe in transformation. I believe in true change. I believe in us having true systems of communal things that are put in place to keep us safe, not police, right? But I know some people are still wondering, okay, well, what do we do? There's a lot of folks out here, a lot of organizations and entities that you could connect with that do this work that can bring you a little bit closer. Because how many times do we have to say names of sisters, of brothers, of children, asking the same question of what are we going to do? Why are we here? Why do the police continue to kill us? They don't know anything else to do but kill us. Right? Why are we here? Why are we here?
Sonya Massey.
Before I stop talking, again, I want to say, I love us. I love Black people. I love Black women and girls. I love Black men. I love Black humans. I love Black queer and trans individuals. I love Black disabled bodies. I love every intersection of Blackness I fucking love. And every demographic and every subset of Black person, we are not a monolith, deserve to live and to be free in this society. And any marginalized group deserves to live and thrive and be free in this world. And until that happens, we will continue to do the work, but we can't do this shit alone. But also, niggas are tired and exhausted, right? So as we're in a state of constant mourning and grief, that's a lot on us, right? Courtney brought it when she first started talking about we're inching up on 10 years of the Ferguson uprising, 10 years of Michael Brown being cut down too soon. And yet here we are, a week before that, lifting up the name of Sonya. In the midst of an unprecedented, people keep saying, election, where you have one candidate that says he wants to give total immunity to police. Which means it definitely won't shit happen to them if they kill anybody else. They have the freedom to go on with their lives. That's crazy. And that's for those who tend to think that, like, going to the other side is somehow free thinking. All right. So Trump wants to give total immunity, like he wants no type of consequence for police for doing their job, i.e. causing terror on communities, specifically communities of color, even more specifically Black folks. So I'm just giving that nugget to some of y'all who are tethering the line of, you know, I'm gonna jump over here because, you know, I don't wanna be a sheep and I wanna be a free thinker and all the whatever bullshit you've been told. Because I don't know how an old ass white man is gonna free Black people, but that's just me. And I'm not gonna get on that soapbox, I'm gonna rather back into why we're here. So as I wrap up, I just wanna say this. I wanna say I love us, I love Black people, I love y'all, I love Black women and girls. I love Sonya Massey, even though I never met her, and every Black person that has been cut down too soon. We deserve to live. We deserve to have copious amounts of joy, joy that is unfleeting. And while we continue to fight against this, I also call us in to be able to experience joy as well, because that's revolutionary. I invite us to also laugh and dance and smile and be able to be in spaces where we are loved and seen in totality while we are continuing to do this fight. Why are we here?
Sonya Massey.
Why are we here?
Sonya Massey.
I love y'all. Peace. You know, the organizers of this event were really conscious that we are not the only ones feeling a thing. So I want to invite just a couple, if you feel it on your heart. And you know how at church service, when they ask people to come speak, they give you 2 minutes. That's a hard 2 minutes. So if you come up on this mic, how many minutes you get? You get 2 minutes, 120 seconds. Not like I'm on my way, I'll beat her in 2 minutes, 2 minutes. Like click, click, 2 minutes, tick tock. And as we are allowing people to come up and speak, I ask that folks share the flame. Let's light up this event for Sonya. And I appreciate y'all passing the flame, because it's important that, you know, the significance of passing the flame. You're supposed to do this. The significance of passing the flame is to show that we are one body. We are one flame. We have to pass the torch to each other. We all have to be a part of illuminating the truth. We all have to be a part of sharing the moment, standing in solidarity. And it takes a community to create the type of light for the world to see. It takes a lot of us. So if you are called, I'm gonna stand up here in solidarity of the 2 minutes. And we're gonna let a few people on the mic.
Hello, my name is Angel Davis Taylor, but I also go by the poetic name of Nabawi T. Shabazz. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus, was all Sonya Massey said. But in less than 5 minutes after speaking his truth, she was dead. He pointed the gun at her face as if her life didn't matter, as if the ancestors that represent her wouldn't go uproar in a chatter. You have awakened the beast in us, Sonya Massey, that we have allowed to sleep too long. Not only will you be on billboards and posters, you will be in our head like the never-ending song. You had a vicious attack on your life that reduced you so they thought to nothing. But we got our boots on the ground, and baby, it is about to be something. We will hold those accountable who felt like her life didn't have no meaning. They will not sleep, they will not eat, and it'll seem like systemically they are blaming. But no, we will not support such chaos. We will not forget her life. We will put our boots to the ground for Sonya Massey, and she is reinventing our life. She was bold in her love for God, and she said, I rebuke you in his son's name. And how dare you take from her her last breath because you didn't feel the same. Sonya Massey, we represent you in every race, shade, creed, and color, and I guarantee you, you will receive justice if I have to do it for all the sons and daughters and mothers.
See, I told you, it's just people out here with talent, words. Anyone else? Okay, we got a couple.
How y'all doing? My name is Clara Holmes. Facebook, Clara's Carol Hart. So I got a heart big as gold. My nephew lost his life in the hand of police brutality. So every time I heard stuff like this, it made me think about him. He lost his life 2 days before his birthday at 17 years old. He got shot by a black and white cop. And a lot of people don't know about that, but you know, he was number 17 years old. It wasn't justified. He got shot 7 times in his back. I really miss my nephew because he was just 17 years old, and nobody never talk about him. Right after Mike Brown, my son got shot, my nephew got shot in the snow 7 times in his back, and it wasn't justified. He was running from the police, they got shot. You know, we got another incident going on right now. Our mother is praying for our son, wondering what's going on. Got us thinking the police has shot him. You know, I know y'all heard about that. We're gonna have to fight for her too. Sonya, we fight for you to the end and hope justice, you know, be served. And, you know, it just don't make no sense. So we still gotta heal and, you know, maintain our life, but justice is gonna be served. We must love and support one another. We need peace in the streets, stop the violence, stand up for our people, Black Lives Matter, stop the violence, you know, indict, convict, send them killer cops to jail. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. I say indict, convict, send them killer cops to jail. The whole damn street is just as hell. Whose street?
Our street.
Whose street?
Our street.
This is what the Massey look like. Show me what the Massey look like. Fuck 12.
Big on the last one. Big on the last one.
Good evening. My name is Toni Roper. I just moved back. I'm born and raised in St. Louis. I just moved back here 7 months ago. Thank you to the organizers of this event. Let's give them a hand, please. Thank you so much. Special Courtney, I've known a long time. I just want to share one thing with you. I just moved back from Central Illinois. Springfield, where Sonya is from, is a second home to me. And I got a message from a friend from there. And they responded to your poster and said, wow. And I said, good or bad, wow. And they said, the people of St. Louis are getting together to do this? They know about this? And I said, everyone in the country knows about this, and we're standing up for this. And they were surprised. So please, keep fighting. And injustice for one is injustice for all. And this is just a great example for that. But they're surprised. Our brothers and sisters, they're here, an hour and a half away from here. So they were surprised, but we just have to keep doing this and looking out for our brothers and sisters everywhere. But I just want to share that. That was messages from yesterday and today from my friends in Springfield, Illinois. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Cheyenne, you coming up?
Hello. So my name is Cheyenne, and I am a part of Expect Us. I just want to say, when Kayla had touched going 10 years later from us continuing to do this work, so many similarities from Sonya Massey and Mike Brown. Just the officer going from different police department to police department, like Darren Wilson. Like, it's just so many things, and I just don't want anyone's name to go unheard, because an injustice anywhere is an injustice where?
Everywhere. Ashe. Thank you, Shane. So thank you all for blessing the mic, blessing the space. I'm gonna ask Belle to come up once more. And, you know, usually in a vigil, there is a moment of silence. We're gonna be silent as Belle plays. We're gonna hold this space. I ask that as Belle comes up, as we hold this collective flame, or we try to hold this collective flame, because the wind is blowing, I see y'all struggling. That we say her name. Say her name.
Sonya Massey.
Say her name.
Sonya Massey.
Say her name.
Sonya Massey.
You know, there's a chant that we usually say at events like this, and I'm just gonna say the words. You don't have to say it back. But it says it is our, and I heard it 10 years ago for the first time. Found out it's the words of Ashada Shakur and her words of another. And it just says, I think it's a mandate. It says, it is our duty to fight for our freedom. And it is our duty to win. And we must love and protect one another. We have nothing to lose but our chains. And 10 years later, y'all, we have nothing to lose but our chains. Because if we don't lose our chains, we will lose our people. And so we have to be willing to fight. We have to continue to show up. We have to continue to amplify. We have to do the work. every day. This has to be a commitment. You understand?
Yeah.
A commitment, like a lifelong one. It's not one person. It's not one shooting. That might have been your entry point. But once you join this space, once you join this army, once you join this movement, every life is worth showing up for. It doesn't matter the story that they tell. It doesn't matter what the headlines say. It doesn't matter how they try to villainize the people. You have to show up. It is a commitment to breaking the chains. It is a commitment to loosening the chains. Because when we resist, we win. It is in the struggle that we win. It is the moment that they hesitate because they know we will show up that we win. It is the moment where the mayor feels like, I don't know if I can increase their budget without resistance. It is the moment where we have to, at all times, apply pressure. I don't know what that was. It was a home run. All right. Great. Right, exactly. So we're gonna let Belle play. And I just ask that you say her name to yourself. You remember that she is a life. She was a life. She was a person deserving to grow old, to see her children grow up, to see her grandchildren be born, to live out her days as she saw fit. As she saw fit, not as we saw fit. There is no such thing as a perfect life. There is no such thing as a path we all have to walk that's the same. Her life, by sheer force of existing, deserved to live out its days uninterrupted. So we're gonna hold space for Sonya, and Belle's gonna play for us. Prepare to rap. I want to introduce our last speaker, and then we're gonna dismiss. We're gonna end it. And my hope is that, you know, this moment you feel grounded in the mandate to show up for each other. That we feel clear that we must enact a vision of safety that does not and will never include the police. That we believe in something that will always bring us together and keep us safe. The chant goes, who keeps us safe?
We keep us safe.
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 So I'm gonna bring up Reverend Michelle Higgins, and
give us the benediction, I guess. And then I think is
the photographer, what's his name?
Somebody gonna take a picture. Pam, somebody help us out. I appreciate it. You wanna say something real quick? Absolutely.
How's everybody doing tonight? By a show of hands from that last chant, how many people out here are really ready to protect the person standing next to them? So everyone that got their hand raised, I'm sure you got a cell phone in the other hand, right? That cell phone is the key to change. I get up every day and I go out and I watch law enforcement. Why? Because as I look out in the crowd, I'm saying, damn, if we had all of these people that's been stood here for the last hour holding your cell phone up, if you would get out in the street and when you see a traffic stop, when you see an officer doing something he ain't got no business, or when you see any one of us interacting with law enforcement, you're supposed to stop, grab your phone, and hold your phone to that situation. Why? Because now it's holding everybody accountable. The officers in St. Louis don't want to be held accountable. It's an officer sitting right on the other side of these bushes right here that I put on YouTube. For what reason? Because he stopped me because I filmed a traffic stop to tell me that it was against the law to film a traffic stop, and he had to conduct an investigation, so he turned off his body camera. Now he's sitting right over there. That's where everybody needs to be. You know what I mean? Yeah, it's good that we all stand here and we chant, but it's things that we can do within the community that will create change. SLMPD District 5, they know my face because I'm there every time they're there. They know not to do nothing wrong. Every time I say, man, it's a camera out here, they say, yo, camera out here. So that lets me know that they know. When they see me pull up, they pull off. Why we all can't have that same effect? Why ain't we taking the time? Now, Sandra Massey, almost a unique case, because like I say, it's only two reasons you deal with the police. One, you call them, and two is a traffic stop. So if you're in a traffic stop, I know you didn't invite that officer to come and talk to you, but if you're having a bad day, if you argue with your girl, you just don't know what to do, and you say, hey, you know what, let me get up, let me go take a drive. You can hit the corner. You get stopped by an officer, and your attitude alone could cost you your life. But your neighbor right there know what you're going through, and instead of speaking up saying, no, that ain't what that is, officer, they will ride past and say that ain't got nothing to do with me, because if the police talking to him, they got a reason to talk to him. And that's not always the case. We can step up and we can do more for each other. All you need to do, pull your phone out and hold them accountable. Because if an officer is doing something to you, he ain't got no business. When I show up, he don't know who I am. He don't know what my business is there for real. He's going to say, sir, move with your camera. But I know my rights. So if you telling me to move with my camera, then that means you violating her. We can't be scared, y'all. We can't be scared. We just got to understand we do have the power. We do have the power. Thank you.
We got some late birds. John Bowman wants to give a couple words too.
Yeah. Hey, I just want to remind everyone, one of my favorite individuals, Malcolm X, once said, the most disrespected group of people on earth is the black woman. And how can we tolerate that when we come from a black woman? when everything that is a part of our existence, who we are, who nurture us, who protects us. I come from a household with a mother and six sisters, very strong black women. I have daughters. I'd be damned if I'm gonna stand on the sidelines and watch my women be mistreated. And we all have to take that attitude. They're taking the front line for us. We gotta stand with them and behind them. No questions asked. I got the call about Sonya Massey right after she was killed. One of my fraternity brothers, that's his cousin. And he was thinking it was in Springfield, Missouri, but it's Illinois. But wherever it is, Illinois, Philadelphia, Cleveland, Mississippi, Missouri, too often, we have to stand up and be heard. And my brother was right. We got to do a better job of taking care of each other. That's what it comes down to. So I appreciate my sister Kayla, Action St. Louis, and all of you who showed up today, because this is where the difference is made, right here.
It was like 80, but I'll let you have it. All right, say her name.
Sonya Massey.
Say it from your belly. Say her name.
Sonya Massey.
Say her name.
Sonya Massey.
Say her name.
Sonya Massey.
Michelle, Reverend Higgins.
We are so close to entering Black August, a time where we study, train, fast, where we prepare to fight for our loved ones who are not only political prisoners, but people who should not be incarcerated at all because the prison industrial complex should not exist. And so I would ask that you remember the words of our brother George Jackson, settle your quarrels, come together, understand the reality of this situation. Fascism is already here. You have already overcome. You are the evidence of things unseen. You are the substance of things hoped for. In our tradition, we say faith is, but I serve a God who believes that all power is in the hands of the people. And so because we know where power really lies, we will never give over our power to anyone who presumes to have it over us. George Jackson reminded us that love is available in revolution. And so whatever our quarrels may be, as we heard earlier, we got some quarrels. Whatever our quarrels may be, love is available in the revolution. Protection is available in the revolution. And beloved, as our ancestor Gwendolyn Brooks gave us, upon the heels of hearing that the government had poisoned her brother Paul Robeson half to death, she gave us these words. Will you receive them as I speak them as a blessing over you? We are each other's harvest. We are each other's business. We are each other's magnitude and bond. Will you take a moment and repeat each line after me from your heart? We are each other's harvest.
We are each other's harvest.
We are each other's business.
We are each other's business.
We are each other's magnitude.
We are each other's magnitude.
We are each other's bond.
We are each other's bond.
Sonya Massey is our harvest.
Sonya Massey is our business. Sonya Massey is our business.
Our people are our magnitude.
Our people are our magnitude.
The revolution is our bond.
The revolution is our bond.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Told you that's how you have a benediction.
All right. Woo.
So we offer for those who desire one of the candles, if you have altars, if you just want to hold space in memory, take one of the candles on the stand. We're going to ask everyone to come up, face that way, and we're going to ask for a picture, if that's all right with you. Thank you. And then we're going to go be each other's business, be each other's bond.
Every day.
Every day. Say our name.
Sonya Massey.
All right, y'all, let's do it.
I
I'm so sorry. Sonya Massey's family was watching an IG live, and they said thank you to the folks who came today. We are each other's magnitude. We are each other's bond. Come this way. Grab a candle, grab a flower.